to your local church should be easy. And with Tithely, it is. Just download the app and securely register your credit or debit card. You're done. Now you can give during church services or anywhere else. Use Tithely to give a one-time gift or set up recurring donations. It's that simple. It's fast, secure, and easy to use. Tithely, the simplest way to give to your local church.
What is a name? Is it more than letters on paper? Is it only the way we start conversation? Your name is a mark that you carry from the beginning. From first breath to final days, your name is the banner you fly for the sake of honor. But for whose honor? Is it for your family, your job, your faith? Is it for the legacy that you leave? Is it for your name to be known throughout history?
Today, our very freedom. Wonderful. Tears down this wall.
What the country can do for you is ask what you
can do. A baby in infamy.
Never surrender.
It all starts at the beginning. Where there was darkness, He spoke light. Where there was a pile of dust, He breathed life. Where captivity seemed eternal, He set us free forever. When the waters rise, He is our gaze. When He burns like a fire before us, there is only one name that He says to proclaim. I am. I am the beginning and the end. I am the creator, the provider, the healer. I am the King Maker, the Righteous One. I am justice, peace, and love. I am Father. A father with arms wide open to welcome the prodigal home. I am the father who, for the sake of freedom, I set you free. My light shines so brightly that no darkness can prevail. I am yours, and you are mine. I am a father who so loved the world that He gave His only Son. Who is this Son? What should we call Him? What is His name? What mark will He bear? What banner will He carry? He shall be called the Messiah, Hosanna, the Healer, Teacher, the Miracle Maker. He is Jesus. Could it be that the Son bears the image of the Father? Could it be that the Son of I Am would say, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the wonder of Christmas.
Oh,
Christmas.
Have a holy, jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holy, jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know.
everybody to our very first Christmas special online here with us at EdenX. Yes. My name is Christopher and this is my lovely wife, hi, Neddie, and we are the leaders and founders of this ministry. We're so honored that you would allow us to go into your living rooms, your cars, your
tablets,
workplace, phones, computers. Man, we're just doing church all kinds of ways.
Yes.
And we're just so honored that you would take the moment to be with us. And we want to take a moment also to honor our guests, right?
Yes,
all of our
you.
First time, second time, third time that you're joining us. This is what we do. We love to serve people. And we're in the Christmas spirit.
Yes!
We're in the Christmas spirit. Robert and Noemi did so awesome.
We love them.
Holly jolly Christmas, man. She brought it.
She's
brought
amazing.
It. We're just
we love
so
you,
grateful.
Noemi.
We thank you, Robert and Noemi, part of our Eden
Robert.
Family. And Kaylen, my God.
Kaylen,
we thank you. We
yes.
love you. We honor you. I'm sure so many people
yes.
were touched and blessed. And, you know, we had a moment with Kaylen where
yes.
we explained to her the importance of bringing the Christmas spirit.
Yes, and
that,
we sure did feel it.
Yes, and that we wanted to share Jesus with people
yes.
With no barriers.
No barriers.
We just wanted to introduce the greatest gift and...
our Savior.
The miracle, right?
Yes.
The real miracle of Christmas,
yes.
and that's Jesus. So we're just so honored, and we're really thankful that you... once again would allow for us to come into
thank
your
you.
Into your space. We want to share a small reflection that I think is going to be powerful, and I think that's going to be something that's going to help you. We want to talk to you a little bit about the true light of His kingdom, and this is a Christmas reflection, okay? And there's a famous song,
mm-hmm.
and we obviously heard it tonight, a famous song called O Holy Night, right? And the lyric might resonate with a lot of you, because one of the lyrics says, a thrill of hope, a weary world rejoices.
Mm.
That's so powerful, especially in these times.
Yes.
We're living in some very difficult and uncertain times.
That's right.
I think we've said that a lot this whole year.
That's right.
I felt like it was yesterday
yes.
when we heard that we were going to be in shelter in place and we heard about this virus
mm-hmm.
and we didn't know the severity of it.
Yes.
And this song, you know, it for a lot of people
yeah.
may seem like a Christmas carol,
mm.
but for a lot of us that are really tuning into the lyric, the weary world rejoices.
Mm.
We want to put that in your heart
yes.
because even if you find yourself weary, there's still a part of that process where you can rejoice,
that's
correct?
Right. That's right.
Many of us have cried many tears this season. A lot of us have felt senseless hope
yes.
and today we're coming to let you know that there was a beautiful night
mm.
where our Savior was born.
That's right.
And that's why we've entitled it O Night
Divine.
So we're entering the Advent season, the arrival of Jesus, and the question that we have for all of
mm-hmm.
the people that are listening is, do you find yourself weary today? Talk to me a little bit about what that means, babe, to feel weary.
We feel weary, especially right now. I think a lot of people, it's the end of the year, and they're feeling either like this either let them down.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not what we want you to feel, but that's what we are feeling. You
mm-hmm.
feel tired. You feel numb. You feel exhausted. And maybe you felt that you've lost hope and you'd rather probably skip this Christmas season. You're
right.
Probably saying, man, can we just either fast
forward.
Close the year, fast forward to next year and see if it's better. But you mentioned something right now and you said, even when you're weary, there's still, I believe, hope
joy.
And joy.
Mm-hmm.
In the midst of any uncertainty.
Correct.
I believe that we've seen the hand of God this year.
And I think it allows for us to reflect
that's
as
right.
well.
Yes.
Because when you really compile all the things that we think are important,
mm.
we start to really cross off all the things that we thought were important
that's
really
right.
are
Amen.
Not important.
No.
You know, especially when you find yourself, you know, in a season
that's right.
of drought,
mm.
in a season where it's almost like we feel like we're taking two steps forward and then having to take three steps back. Mm-hmm. The country's getting better, mm-hmm. and then it gets worse. Mm-hmm. And then we feel like we got a good grasp on this pandemic, and then they tell us we got to shut down again. Mm-hmm. What does that do to the people, right? Mm-hmm. And the thing that we reflected on is the most important and most valuable space and surrounding that you have is your family.
That's right.
You can embrace your family.
You find security.
You find security.
In the time that this world's not feeling secure, they're mm-hmm. losing hope, you feel, you don't know whether to trust the news, the media, or to trust people.
Sure.
Because basically, this season has made people separate instead of get close together, yeah. right?
That's real talk, mm-hmm. you know. We've often shared that this isn't the season to separate from each other. This isn't the separate to give up.
That's right.
This isn't the season for us to shut down.
That's right.
This is the season for us to hold the people we love tighter.
That's right.
This is the season that we embrace one another.
Amen.
And that we encourage one another.
Amen.
And one of the things that we wanted to share with you is that you are not alone.
Yes.
You're not alone.
No.
And I know that you miss the warmth of the people. Mm. You miss the social gatherings.
Yeah.
You miss being able to sit down and have a cup of coffee.
That's it. That's
at coffee. A coffee shop. We've been having a lot of coffee at home. And it's
not the same.
It's not the same. It's beautiful, but there's nothing like really being in a space where you can mingle with other people.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think it's important for us to share that we have a faith.
That's right.
And we are people of faith.
Yes.
And we belong to a body of
Christ.
Of Christ.
Yes.
And, you know, in the body of Christ, there's so many parts.
Mm-hmm.
But the Word of God reminds us that we become one body.
That's right.
We all have different functions,
That's right.
different ideas, different ways of how we do things.
Mm-hmm.
I might tie my shoes different than her.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, the Word of God really inspires us to press into the people we love.
Love one another.
You know?
To forgive one another. To understand one another.
And yeah. you go back and think about what was the Advent message. And we talked about the light of His kingdom.
That's right.
What does that really mean? Especially in this time. You know, you have to understand that from the Old Testament to the New Testament, some scholars may debate, but they've come up with a certain number that they say there was a moment of silence where they didn't hear God. 450 to 500 years from the book of Malachi to the New Testament. And when you see that huge gap,
that silence,
and they had just heard, right? And they were waiting for the Messiah.
Wow.
They were waiting for the arrival of the Prince of Peace. The Messiah, the Savior of the world. And then I go back and I think about this, babe. How many people today are living their Malachi to Matthew moment?
Wow.
Where they're waiting for the arrival of the miracle.
That's right. Hallelujah.
They're waiting for the arrival of the good news.
Mm.
Many people are in
peace, are in
emergency rooms
That's
today.
Right.
You know, I struggle, babe, going on Facebook. Because instead of seeing it, this is my humble observation.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like in this season, instead of seeing more people holding online services, which there's many, it just seems like this past month or so has been where a lot of people are sharing funerals and prayer requests.
Hallelujah.
And people asking for a petition.
Yes.
Because they have a loved one who's dying of COVID. Or somebody who's fighting for their lives. And maybe this is their Malachi to Matthew moment. Where they're waiting, where's the Jesus that we've been talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Where's the arrival of this miracle? And the true light of God's kingdom, when we talk about it, is that the prophet Isaiah in chapter 9, verse 6, reveals to us, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and finish it.
The Prince of Peace.
And we're here to share with you that what the prophet had prophesied came to pass.
That's right.
There was the birth of this king named Jesus that comes with a government.
Hallelujah.
He comes with a way of living. He comes to deposit into us the greatest miracle. And we get to be a part of this kingdom, Neddie.
That's right, yes.
Simply because of the power of his blood.
Amen.
And what he did on the cross.
Yes, thank you, Father.
But it doesn't stop there.
No.
We can't just live to be saved.
That's right.
We have to live to experience his redemptive power.
Amen.
His redemption for us.
That's right.
The word of God says that he takes us from slavery and he adopts us as sons of God.
That's right.
And although today may seem like it's dark, like there is a valley, people are trying to figure out where's the light switch. What's the best way for us to cope with what's going on?
Be the light.
And the prophet said, listen, I want you to know that there is a child that is born. There is a son that is given. And he comes with heaven's influence so that we can influence the earth.
That's right.
And that it doesn't finish in the ER room.
No.
And it doesn't finish with your COVID positive test results.
No.
That it doesn't finish with you being jobless.
Yes.
It doesn't finish with somebody dying of cancer in the hospital. It doesn't finish if you're going hungry.
Mm.
It doesn't finish if you can't pay the rent. It doesn't finish if all that's been in your family and in your home has been fighting and bickering because you've had to shelter in place.
Mm.
But the word of God reminds us, and I want my wife once again to share what the prophet called the Savior of this world. He was Wonderful,
Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace.
He wants to be the peace
Father.
In this season. He wants to be wonderful to you. He wants to counsel you.
Yes.
He wants to be the Mighty God. He wants to be your Everlasting Father, our Everlasting Father. And we want to come and encourage you through this online experience, this Christmas online experience, O Night Divine. We put all of this together for you so that you can take this seed and that you can plant it in the center of your home, right next to your Christmas tree, so that you can unwrap it and share with your kids the real reason for Christmas is that Jesus Christ came to this earth and he came to give us a new way of living.
Amen.
He came to give us a new influence. He's come to give us keys
Amen.
That will unlock doors that have been locked unto us.
Right.
He's come to take us out of our misery. And he's come to heal our bodies.
Yes.
But more than that, listen to this, more than that, he's come to give us the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you.
So that the Holy Spirit can be the peace in the midst of our trials.
That's right, especially now.
Especially today.
We need the Holy Spirit.
We need the Holy Spirit
yes.
to invade our homes.
That's right. More than ever.
To invade our churches.
Yes.
To invade marriages. To invade families.
Yes.
We need the Prince of Peace. And his name is Jesus Christ. And he wants to live inside of you.
Yes.
So my friend, we once again want to remind you that tonight is not about us.
No.
It's not about our participants and our guests. We'll put all this together to give glory to one,
Jesus
Christ.
Thank
and
you.
That he can be a part of your life.
Mm-hmm.
He can live in inside of you. And if you will open your heart.
Just open it.
The book of Revelation says, if he knocks and you open, he'll come in.
That's right.
He'll come in and share a meal with you.
That's right.
He'll come in and dine with you. He'll come
that's
in
beautiful.
And share his life with
yes.
you. And that's what Jesus has come to
yes.
do. So babe, I want you to pray. For all those mothers, all
yes.
those young ladies that today are feeling weary, they need a boost
Amen.
In their faith.
Amen. Let's
or maybe
pray.
Somebody who's out there that says, I just kind of ran into this program.
Welcome.
But I want you to pray, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pray for all the all the guys and all the men that are needing our prayers out there. So,
Holy Spirit, we come before you today, thanking you, for this time, for all the homes and the ears that are listening to us, and all the homes that are, Lord Jesus, listening to your word right now. Lord, we pray, God, for every single mom, every single lady out there, every woman out there that is, Lord, listening to this word, Father, that you are our Savior, you are our Comforter, you are our Prince of Peace. If they are feeling weary, God, I pray, Father, that you give them peace, that, Lord Jesus, in this time of uncertainty, God, bring, Lord Jesus, joy. Lord, that, Lord, they will see through this storm, Lord, that, Lord, you are there and you've always been there, Father, for us. Lord, Father, Lord, answer all their prayers, Father. Let them know that you've always have been there, Lord, listening to, Lord, their voice, our voice. Lord Jesus, answer all prayers, God. Give them strength like never before, God. Renew their strength, God, like eagles, God. And let them, Lord, know that they are loved. They are loved by you. Let them know, Lord Jesus, that they are, Lord Jesus, beautiful. That they are wonderfully made, Father. And give them, Lord, joy in the midst of, Lord Jesus, of this season, God. Let them feel the peace that comes, Lord Jesus, through serving you, Lord, and allowing you to be, Lord Jesus, and come into our hearts, God. Lord, we thank you for this day, Lord. And I bless all the ladies, God. I bless their children. And I declare blessings over their homes right now. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen. For all the champions that are listening to the sound of my voice, all of the men, the lions, the leaders, the pastors of their homes, I speak this word of faith and this word of encouragement over your life. This is a very tough season to lead in. This is where you demonstrate how strong and fierce and relentless you are. This is the time to rise up. All the men, this is the time that we rise up and that we declare and wave the flag that we men are going to lead our families in the ways of the Lord. And I declare over you strength as of an eagle. I declare over you the greatest move of God in your life, that the Holy Spirit will become so real in your life, that when you lead, you will not be afraid, that when you lead, you will take risks for the glory of God. And I declare over you supernatural strength. I declare over you a wisdom that only comes from heaven, from the Holy Spirit. And as we take charge and lead in our homes, that we will feel the support of heaven. And I love you, Jesus, for what you're doing in the lives of every man that's listening to me. Young men that feel weary and tired and feel like everything that you've been doing leading up to today just led you nowhere. I want to encourage you that every step that you're taking is just another step towards your future and towards your destiny. And we declare over your life as well supernatural strength and wisdom from God. And I thank you, God, for strengthening families, strengthening marriages, strengthening leaders, faith leaders, career-orientated people today, God. I thank you. And I also feel the urge in the Holy Spirit to pray for every business owner. Every business owner that feels that they're going to have to close their doors. I want you to know that there's going to be a supernatural shift in your business economically. But I want to remind you that the best way to keep your doors open is if you honor God with your first fruits. If you honor God with your economy, God is going to make a way where there is no way. And I declare over all of the entrepreneurs and business owners today, you will not shut the doors in Jesus' name. Churches, I pray for you as well. Pastors and leaders, I want you to know we will withstand. We will get through this in the name of Jesus. And we are going to experience the greatest revival that the eye has not seen. And we thank you for the strength that we feel in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, for being the miracle of Christmas. And we love you in Jesus' name, in behalf of the entire EdenX family and community. We love you. We honor you in the Lord. And we're just so grateful for our team, you know, that was able to put this together. We honor everybody who worked tirelessly to make this happen. And I have one more announcement. We do have a giveaway, a Christmas giveaway. Man, if you're telling me you don't like coffee, then get off this live stream. I'm just playing. But we're giving 5 Starbucks cards, man. Five. Virtual cards. No contact, social distance. We'll send you the barcode. But right now, on this, on our comments section, right now, Lucy and George, our virtual care directors in San Jose, right now, are going to draw the names of the 5 winners. Yes. And drum rolls, right? We're excited for whoever wins this, and enjoy a cup of coffee. And when you do, it's coming from EdenX Ministries here in the Bay Area. Every single time you take a sip, you're going to know it came from a great, great family. We love you, and we appreciate you. And once again, Merry Christmas.